It was a joyous occasion for Bangladesh, a golden jubilee celebration of the country's independence and marking the birth centenary of the country's founder, Sheikh Mujibur Rahman. But the celebration was marred by the protests underway in Dhaka. While the demonstration started as an opposition to the Indian Prime Minister's visit to the country, this was just an excuse to mask the real reason behind the violence. Bangladesh is reeling under extremism, one that is now threatening its economic development. Our correspondent, Lakmina Jasmine Soma, brings you this next report from Ground Zero. Take a look.
Violent protests in Dhaka. 13 people killed in clashes. Several Hindu temples targeted. Incidents of arson and vandalism. And a security threat to Sheikh Hasina's government. The group behind this violence is the Hefazat-e-Islam, a name that calls for saving Islam. Formed in 2010, it is based in Qaumi Madrasa in Bangladesh. It grew into prominence a few years later, showing power on the streets through protests.
Well, it is not only a threat for Sheikh Hasina, it's a threat for the entire country. It's a question of our national security, it's a question of our regional security. It's a threat for the entire South Asian countries. The way Islamic militancy or this terrorist Islam is gaining his pace, it is a matter of great concern for all the countries in South Asia, including Pakistan.
Digging a bit deeper, and the sinister plot becomes more evident. The Hefazat-e-Islam is not alone. Behind its power is mobilization by another group called Jamaat-e-Islam, a pro-Pakistan political party. The Jamaat-e-Islam has always been against Bangladesh's independence, and now that the country is celebrating 50 years of it, its idea was to mar those celebrations with violence. Although banned from contesting elections, Jamaat is one of the major allies of Bangladesh's opposition party. This recent violence has once again brought to fore the horrors of the past.
In 1971, during the Liberation War of Bangladesh, we have seen that they have certain agendas, that is, they want to keep Bangladesh with Pakistan. Later, they wanted to convert Bangladesh into another mini Pakistan. And that's the reason why Bangabandhu Sheikh Mujibur Rahman, he banned formation of political parties on the basis of religion. You know, in 1971, they killed 3 million people in the name of Islam. They molested officially 200,000 women and unofficially 500,000 women in the name of Islam. So political Islam is a big threat for Bangladesh right now.
The Election Commission of Bangladesh scrapped the registration of Jamaat-e-Islami Bangladesh, a religion-based political party, in 2018. Then this controversial party lost their right to do politics in Bangladesh. Since then, they have been trying to march with various Islamist groups like Hefazat-e-Islam. They are trying to achieve their goals under the banner of another party. And when the opportunity arises, they take to the street to show their existence. The result is widespread violence and loss of life.
The group began its protests on March 26th in Dhaka, the day Prime Minister Modi was scheduled to visit the nation. When the police tried to get the situation under control, violent clashes broke out, spreading across Bangladesh. The strike continues even after the visit. There was violence in Chittagong, the commercial capital of Bangladesh. In Brahmanbaria district, Hefazat-e-Islam activists wreaked havoc. Important institutions, including press club, police station, temples, and railway stations, were vandalized.
If necessary, the blood of thousands of brothers will be shed. Yet we will not allow Islam to be deducted. We will not allow Bangladesh to be tarnished. We have given blood, we have given life, we will give more if necessary. Hefazat was and will be for Islam. Remember, the next Bangladesh will be the Bangladesh of Hefazat-e-Islam.
The warning is an ominous one. Hefazat-e-Islam has clear anti-India motives and the group has not been shy about it. But that's not the only aim. The idea is to create an atmosphere of radicalization. one that threatens Bangladesh's growth and independence, and is a threat to entire South Asia. Bureau Report, WION, World is One.
WION World is One is now available in your country. Download the app now and get all the news updates on the move.